I'm Jason, UFC, and today we have a story about UFC number one ranked welterweight contender Colby Chaos Covington would love to slap Sean Strickland around after UFC 296 title win. Colby Covington is not impressed with Sean Strickland's shtick. Chaos Covington has become as well known for his headline-grabbing quotes as he has his impressive in-cage accomplishments in the UFC over the past few years, the combination of which has positioned him for another crack at the undisputed welterweight title when he, Covington, challenges Leon Rocky Edwards at UFC 296 this Saturday here in Las Vegas. Ahead of that welterweight grudge match, Covington spoke to Cold Sports, who asked the fighter for Covington's thoughts on another fighter with a quote, devil may care attitude on the mic. UFC undisputed middleweight champion Sean Tarzan Strickland. This is what Covington says about Sean Strickland. He, Sean Strickland, pretending to be everything he wishes I was, Covington said. I'd love to slap Sean Strickland around. Sean Strickland's just a pathetic excuse of a human being. The guy has literally no freaking IQ. The guy so freaking stupid. The thing he says he needs to get his wires shut. And I am the guy to do it. The UFC knows I'm the one that can end these guys that hate the company and they hate the world. So I'd love to fight Sean Strickland. Sean Strickland has developed a reputation. This is what, back to the article. Sean Strickland has developed a reputation for saying whatever he wants in interviews and on social media, which has occasionally ruffled feathers even as his popularity has grown. His Sean Strickland's rise was punctuated by a stunning 5-round title victory performance against Israel Adesanya at UFC 293, and he is set to defend his middleweight title on January 20th, 2024 at UFC 297 versus Dricus du Plessis. That's going to be an new situation there. The middleweight division has no shortage of contenders who would love to take their shot at Sean Strickland. It's unclear if Covington would be able to jump the line if he defeated Leon Edwards and then immediately move up. When it was suggested that he face another contender like Covington face another contender like former middleweight champion Robert Whittaker, Covington wasn't receptive. No, that ship has sailed, Covington said. He lost the title and then he got beat in a contender fight. So he, Robert Whittaker, just not relevant anymore. Wow. Robert Whittaker doesn't make sense for me. I'm the top of the division. I'm about to be the undisputed UFC welterweight champion of the world. And so I only want to fight the biggest and best UFC has to offer, and I know they wouldn't even waste my time and waste their time to try to put that fight together. This is a business, and they, UFC, want to make money, so it's all about making the biggest and best fights for the fans and for the UFC. Whatever the UFC says, they know I, Covington, am a yes man. I, Covington, am a company man. Whatever they say, Colby Chaos Covington will agree on. Okay, yeah, there's a lot going on in that article. Wow, okay. So, yeah, I mean, who knows what's going on with Covington and Sean Strickland. I didn't know they were even going back and forth. Sean Strickland in the last few weeks has been talking about Ian Garry, which these are welterweight contenders. I personally, listen, I'm an MMA casual, so I don't follow everything in the sport, but has Sean Strickland talked about Dricus du Plessis since the fight has been announced? I know he's going back and forth with Ian Garry. Colby Covington is calling him out now. Has Sean Strickland said anything about fighting Dricus du Plessis? But back to Covington, I mean, you know, it's always worrisome, right, before a fighter gets into a match that they're booking the next fight after that for themselves, right? You just had Paul Craig versus Brendan Allen. He was talking like, you know, after he wins this fight, he's gonna fight three times next year, and people like Bo Nickel, and they're not even on his radar, and then he loses the fight and no one's asking him about his next opponent anymore, you know? So I think it's a bit much for Colby Covington to be booking his fight after Leon Edwards. Leon Edwards is not an easy fight. Leon Edwards is on like a, 10-year win streak, you know? His last loss was against Kamaru Usman a very, very long time ago, and Leon Edwards just defeated Kamaru Usman not once but twice in a row, and Kamaru Usman has two victories over Colby Chaos Covington. And what happens if Colby Chaos Covington does win? Who would be his, you know, he's not going to just jump up to the middleweight division. Like, that almost wouldn't make any sense. There's a lot of contenders that Colby Chaos Covington, you know, should have to see in the middle, in the welterweight division before he moves up to the middleweight division. And also, you know, the fact that he, we didn't get the full context of this interview, but Sean Strickland is booked against Dricus du Plessis for UFC 297 in Canada. What was Colby Covington's opinion about Dricus du Plessis? Is he saying that he thinks Dricus du Plessis is going to lose that fight, so he's not going to answer the question like he said with Robert Whittaker, right? And you know, so that's interesting, because I basically have Dricus du Plessis winning that fight there. And I think a lot of people have Leon Edwards defeating Colby Covington. There was a lot of talk that when Colby Chaos Covington got this fight, people like Matt Brown, Bilal Muhammad came out and said that, you know, if Colby loses this fight, he's probably going to retire. This would be his third undisputed welterweight championship fight that he lost. He probably would retire after that, you know. I personally don't think he's going to retire, you know. I hope he doesn't retire, but it's, you know. Besides, before we go into beating Leon Edwards and, you know, going after Sean Strickland, who may not even be the middleweight champion at that point, I think Colby, you know, I'm pretty sure his entire focus is literally on Leon Edwards. Because, I mean, listen, even in this interview, it says that he was, you know, Colby Covington spoke to Cold Sports, who asked the fighter his thoughts on another fighter, right? I think the thing that we get lost with some of these interviews and some of these headlines is that we just see Colby Covington would love to slap Sean Strickland around after UFC 297. You know, it's like a very, 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 very condensed interview with like a headline. Like, you know, it wasn't like Colby Covington sat down and just say, listen, after I defeat Leon Edwards at UFC 296, I'm gonna go and slap around Sean Strickland. They asked him, right? The interview asked him, asked Colby Covington his thoughts on Sean Strickland. Maybe that's why he didn't answer about, maybe that's why he didn't say anything about the fight between Dricus du Plessis versus Sean Strickland. You know, in the interview, he was asked about this. This wasn't Colby Covington just shooting off, saying like, hey, you know, after I defeat Leon Edwards, I'm going to go and slap Sean Strickland around. But yeah, let me know your opinion of this story. I personally think Dricus du Plessis is going to defeat Sean Strickland, so this may be a moot point. And I'm rooting for Colby Covington to defeat Leon Edwards this weekend at UFC 296. But the odds are not that far. I thought Leon Edwards would be like a 2-1 favorite. Last time I saw it, well, it was pretty close to like 2-1. I think it was like a minus 190, 180 for Leon Edwards. But let me know, who do you think is going to win this fight for UFC 296? Are you thinking Team Chaos or are you Team Rocky? I'm going to be Team Chaos. You know, I'll be Team Chaos just for this one fight. But let me know your opinion of this story. I'm Jason, UFC. Today we had a story about UFC number one ranked welterweight contender Colby Chaos Covington would love to slap Sean Strickland around after his UFC 296 undisputed welterweight title win versus Leon Rocky Edwards. Hit the like button, hit the subscribe button, hit the donation button, and please tune in to the next video on this channel. Thanks a million for watching.